Well, who had Blake Baggett and Justin Barsha in the preseason pool of who would win the first two rounds of Monster Energy Supercross? Not anybody. The unpredictable early season that everyone wants to see has actually turned into reality in 2019. Barsha wins round one, does okay here at round two in Glendale, Arizona, State Farm Stadium. But it is Blake Baggett breaking through for his first ever win. So last week we had a rider winning for the first time in 6 years. This week we have a guy winning for the first time ever. And boy, did Baggett earn it. He had to come through the pack. And that included even catching and passing the defending series champion to get the lead. That's his old adversary, Jason Anderson, but Baggett kept it clean and went on to win his first ever 450 Supercross victory, also for the Rocky Mountain ATV MC WPS KTM team. It is a shocker, but that's only part of it. As a matter of fact, the fact that Anderson was back up there and finished second and led some laps, I don't know if we could say that was a surprise, but certainly a big turnaround from what we saw Anderson do last week at Anaheim, where he finished a lowly 14th, and Anderson admitted in a roundabout way the number one plate, the pressure is being pulled in a lot of directions. Last week really had an effect on him. He was glad to start riding this week like he was during the week leading up to Anaheim 1. He just struggled last time. So big improvement for Anderson to finish second. But that wasn't the entire story. Ken Roczen, who didn't really look that good in qualifying or his heat race, as he said, turned it around in the main event. He got the whole shot and he rode great. But Anderson went to the inside. They tangled. It was kind of a classic Supercross block pass. Roczen went down. Crowd was a little mad at Anderson for that one because Roczen's a big crowd favorite. But Roczen wasn't mad, and Anderson apologized a lot. He had the lead, and at that point, it looked like the race was his. But how about Baggett tracking him down from 2.1 seconds back to get the lead and get the win? Another crazy thing in this race was a staggered restart. We had a red flag come out after Malcolm Stewart, who was incredibly fast in qualifying and in his heat race and was riding really well in the main. He's making up a lot of his time in the whoops, and unfortunately, you're going that fast. If things go wrong, it's going to hurt. And Malcolm did miss a whoop with the front wheel, went down hard, and was knocked out on the track. We heard he might have hurt his leg, and they couldn't clear the track. They red flagged the race, and they had it clicked off enough laps to do a staggered restart, leaving Roczen in the number one spot and Anderson behind him. It was a strange scenario we don't see very often at Supercross, but at least early in 2019, we're getting used to things that we're not used to seeing, like a rider winning round one, his first win in 6 years, or a rider winning round two, his first win ever. Incidentally, Roczen on the podium both races, he's actually your points leader right now, but it's darn close. This field is deep, and it's really hard to predict what's coming next, especially because of what's coming next. A triple crown race in Anaheim 2. That's going to be wild. See you then.